So let's continue with the incremental conductive method. In incremental conductive method, the controller measures the incremental changes in photovoltaic array current and voltage rating in order to predict the effects of voltage change. This method requires more computation in controller part, but can track the changing conditions more effectively as compared to the perturb and observe method. In this method, we increase the operating voltage if the rate of change of power with respect to voltage is positive, and we decrease the operating voltage if the rate of change of power with respect to voltage is a negative value. So the maximum power point tracking is obtained when this derivative of power with respect to voltage is zero. So look at this curve. This is the IV characteristic curve, and it can be seen when the rate of change is zero. This is actually the knee at which we choose our operating system to be operating for its maximum power efficiency. At this point, the rate of change of power curve with respect to voltage will be equal to zero. So seeing into the mathematics, we can write that dp, derivative of power with respect to voltage, is given by p equals vi, and using product rule we can find out that this rate of change of power with respect to voltage can be given by the relation I plus v times di by dv. At maximum power point, the derivative of power with respect to voltage will be zero. So the equation will be zero equals I current plus voltage times the rate of change of current with respect to voltage. So this equation can be rearranged like this, and this, if sampling steps are small enough, we can use the delta can be written as a derivative, and the derivative of I with respect to V will be approximately equal to delta I by delta V for a smaller step size. So to the left of the maximum power point, the derivative will be greater than zero. Therefore, the delta I by delta V will be negative of I by V. Similarly, to the right side of the maximum power point, the delta I by delta V will be less than I by V. So to the left it will be greater than this, and to the left it will be less than this. So this is an example of overall the system. It will look like this. This is the solar panel, and these are the array diodes which isolate the array from batteries at night, so that it is basically acting as a preventer from acting as a load at night. So these diodes ensure that the current is in unidirectional flow. This is the PWM switching regulator which ensures that the maximum peak power tracking controllers are operating at the optimal conditions. And this is the final DC to AC converter which will provide loads to different connected loads. This is the battery charger, and this is the charge current controller. The batteries are used to store the power left over after servicing all the loads, and the charge controller basically keeps the track of battery SOC by controlling the system signal, such as the array and the battery charging currents and the voltages, and activates the dump load if the battery is fully charged and there is still some residual power left.